sustainability and infrastructure is becoming a policy prerequisite. This technology is made of composite material, no steel reinforcement, and will not corrode. If you can build a bridge that'll last over 100 years, and you can do that in a competitive, price-effective manner, it makes economic sense, it makes environmental sense, it makes operational sense.
We are in Duval, Washington State, at the Louts Creek Fish Passage Project.
We are excited. It's an innovative material and innovative design that we are using for the first time in the Pacific Northwest. The advantage is the lightweight of the composite arches, so it doesn't require a heavy crane for installation.
Yesterday, we were setting the arches, and there wasn't a person on the job site that wasn't smiling. It was so fast, and it was so much fun, and there were great big pieces that were all coming together quickly.
The connection of the arch to the foundation part of that is the fixed type of connection that we are looking for in seismic performance.
Bridges haven't changed in 40 years, you know, for the most part, so it's really fun to be a part of something that's brand new.
We probably use a fifth of the concrete required to build one of our arch structures. Cement production is one of the highest, if not the highest, energy intensive manufacturing processes that there are in the world. So by us reducing that amount of concrete, we're contributing to that sustainability and reducing that environmental footprint. AIT has become a member of the Institute for Sustainable Infrastructure.
ISI's Envision Framework effectively is a close cousin to LEED certification for infrastructure. It provides a standard. It provides a definition of what sustainability is. It is necessary that as a matter of public policy, we review and analyze the opportunity to use more sustainable materials, not only in our bridge building, but in other structures. For the small and medium bridge market particularly, the use of composites needs to become a standard.
My experience with this technology really started when the first girders were tested 2.5 years ago now. That was a great experience to watch that get tested to the Strength 1 design requirements. There's really no guesswork. We know what the materials in these girders are. We know how strong they are.
The purpose of the CT girder design was to really reinvent the way we use composites. It was designed very uniquely to think not just about the lightest weight structure, but to think from how do I transport it to the site? How do I erect it at the site? How do I maintain it during its lifetime? And how do I reuse it? If you have a bridge that lasts twice as long, instead of building two bridges, you're building one bridge. And that's, you've cut your environmental footprint significantly.
You want to build structures that are going to be long-lasting. Sustainability has to do a lot with durability. You don't have to go out there and do maintenance. For instance, if you compared it to a steel structure, you have to go out there and take care of corrosion. So you have to repaint it. If you use a composite type of reinforcing GFRP, then you eliminate all the issues that go with corroding steel. And what are they using today out in California to strengthen concrete for earthquake, for seismic? They wrap it in composites. So if you're using it for repair, why can't you use it initially to build?
We like innovative stuff. We've seen some composite girders, but they were all filled with concrete. The weight's always a factor. The speed in which we can move them around and manipulate them, spin them, hold them, is very simple because of the weight.
You can put two girders together, install the utilities, and lower them all into place at the same time. You don't need heavy equipment, and it goes in a day and a half.
More of the contractors can bid with their means and methods. They don't need necessarily the giant crane that, you know, three or four companies have, which always means you allow more people to compete for the project, and that lowers the bid prices. There isn't any DOT that would tell you that they have enough money. If there's one, I'd love to meet them. And I think part of our obligation as departments of transportation is to really push out the longevity of our bridges. If we can find products that give us another 25 years of life in a bridge, that is real money you don't have to spend into the future. There's a sustainableness about this girder, not as energy intense as other products. That's a benefit for a state like Maine that's really looking at climate and trying to reduce emissions.
Advanced infrastructure technologies build things that last longer. As a result, we save time and money and energy. We produce a sustainable product that is better for the marketplace, better for taxpayers. We intend to lead in changing the way things have been done up to this point.